I'm really excited. We've got two beautiful demonstrations to show you. One's a real classic, the ammonia fountain. The other one is a completely new one we've invented ourselves, called Neil's Balloon. They're both based on the fact that ammonia gas is very soluble in water. And when it dissolves in water, the water goes alkaline. So if you put in an indicator that is colourless in water and red in alkaline, when the ammonia goes in, the water goes red. And we use the indicator phenolphthalein. The classic experiment is called the ammonia fountain. It consists of a large glass bulb filled with ammonia, which has a cork or bung in the bottom with a glass tube going through it about halfway up the flask. And the idea is that if you put the bottom of the tube into water, the ammonia starts dissolving in the water. It creates a partial vacuum because you're absorbing gas and so the pressure is going down, and the pressure of the atmosphere pushes more water into the flask, more ammonia dissolves, so more water goes in. Now, the problem was we set it all up, Neil set it all up, he put ammonia into the flask. Ammonia is lighter than air, so you can just fill the flask in up by putting a tube inside it. And he then put the bung into the flask. And then before we started, we had the tube just above the surface of a large jar of water. And enough ammonia was coming out to start triggering the indicator. And the most beautiful red threads started appearing in the jar. I was so excited, I nearly wanted to stop there. Then we lowered the tube into the water, but there wasn't enough difference in pressure to get it started. So Neil and I decided to pour some liquid nitrogen over the top, which cooled the ammonia, reduced its pressure, and therefore began to suck in the water. And once the water started going in, it was really beautiful. Neither Neil or I had ever seen it before. There was a slight problem that the bung hadn't been pushed in quite hard enough, so little air was leaking in as well, but that caused bubbling, which probably added to the effect. And for reasons that I don't quite understand, that as it went on, the form of the liquid film that was on the glass surface changed a bit. So there was an ever-changing patterns. And also the colour of the indicator changed quite a bit. So it was really nice. Before we go on to the next one, just let me remind you, the reaction here is ammonia dissolving in water, making it slightly alkaline. And the red colour is not part of the reaction, but it's an indicator to show you that the water is alkaline. The next demonstration, or really it's an experiment because we didn't know whether it would work, began with my idea that we should try filling a balloon with ammonia, because ammonia is lighter than air, so I just wondered whether a balloon of ammonia would float. Not something you'd want to use at a party, because if it burst there'd be a smell, but it does float quite nicely. Then we remembered that if you put sticky tape onto a balloon, you can then stick a pin or a needle through the tape into the balloon without bursting it. The reason for this is that when you normally prick a balloon, when you make the first hole, the fabric runs from that hole and a slit goes up through the fabric and it breaks. But if you have the rubber held by sticky tape, it can't move. So we had the idea that we should try injecting water with phenolphthalein into the balloon. What we hoped was that the water would absorb the ammonia, so the pressure would go down and the balloon would shrink. Of course, with the fountain, the size of the flask can't change, And of course, it fills up with just more and more water. So the idea here was to be a much simpler demonstration that we could do perhaps more quickly. Before we started filming, Neil practiced with a syringe needle in a nitrogen balloon, just sticking the needle in. It worked perfectly. But then when we started filming, the first balloon needle went in, there was an almost bang. And we all ran out of the room because of the smell of ammonia. The ammonia disperses very quickly, so it's not dangerous. So for the third time, I suggested we went to sellotape or scotch tape rather than plastic tape. And we used a bigger needle so we could inject the liquid faster. And it worked beautifully. When the liquid went in, the ammonia started being absorbed and the balloon beautifully shrank. But what we didn't realise, because Neil was holding it, was that when ammonia dissolves in water, it produces a lot of heat. There is a positive heat of dissolution, a heat of reaction. So the balloon was actually getting hotter and hotter, and Neil nearly dropped it. However, he managed to hang on till the balloon went from this sort of size to about the size of my clasped hands. We were all really very pleased. In a way, it's a nicer demonstration to show how the gas is disappearing into the liquid than the traditional ammonia fountain, because in that, the size of the flask doesn't change. But really, both of them are fun, and I hope you enjoyed them.